What's good, superstars? Back with another So Rare video. You got Superstar Joe. You got Superstar Rob in the building. How's it going, Rob?
Pretty good, you?
Fastball. guys, if you are new here, do not forget. Become a superstar. Smash the subscribe button down below. Hit the bell notification so you know whenever we're posting a So Rare video. We're going through our team. We're trying to upgrade it and make it into the best fantasy team around. If you don't know about So Rare, you're going to learn about it pretty quickly here in this video. You can also become a superstar VIP, $2.99 a month. We give a star away in the universe every single month. So end of today's video, we will be taking a snapshot. And then during this week, we will be giving away the star for April. So if you wanted to be in that giveaway, today's the last chance. But then you can be entered into May if you join tomorrow or so on. There's a bunch of other perks, first dibs on merch, all other kinds of things that you can get. By being in the VIP. And thank you to all of those who have been supporting us. Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, if you want to follow us. We have a Discord with So Rare chat in the description. So definitely go check that out if you want to learn more. There's people giving tips. Tron, shout out to Tron in the Discord, helping people out learn how to play the game. Really, really useful. And also, we have a PO box if you want to send us something, become a Superstar Hall of Famer. Shout out to all the VIP members who have continued to support us for over a year. Ridiculous.
Yeah. I'll actually look forward to our weekly solar videos just because fantasy is a lot of fun right now. I know there's the NHL playoffs that are going on. Yeah. But in terms of the baseball, day to day, you got games every single day. You can help you stay engaged in the game. And that's why I think solar is going to do very well.
Yep. So let's get into the solar Twitter news. So this was last week. We did have the number one player on our team, Adolis Garcia, who ended that's up right. with 90 points.
Yeah, we had
second place was 58. So take that in. That was a huge disparity.
He killed it with those three homers.
We also had Kevin Gausman, who was also tied for ninth, and Zach Gallen. We had both of them.
That's right. That's right.
We had a pretty good lineup. I wish we had Guerrero, but we did not.
No. Three of the top 10, though. I mean, that's why we finished like 85th out of like 20,000.
Yeah. Insane. Insane. Yeah. It was fun, though. That was a fun week. Some people just posting their stuff out here. Name a player. They're taking in tips since it's present day. Name a player you want to find in your rewards. It's really cool to see when you get those players on Monday or on Thursday, whenever it is that the thing turns over.
Yeah. It's so exciting every single time you get to set your team, and that's why we're going to do it right now in a bit.
Yep. So we're getting more players taking part. Willie Adames. Also taking part. People are asking they're asking which competitions you normally play in. I'll go first. Minor. So minor is one of the entry level tournaments. That's one that we also play in. We put our main team in there last week. But we also did set a major team just for the XP. We'll show you that in just a second.
You know what, before you move on there, it kind of reminds me a little bit of like how like soccer leagues are run. It's a very capitalist mentality, right? Yeah. You got to go out, so you start off, you're doing these minor competitions, you have common cards, they're not, you know, you're learning the ropes, and then you have to basically start building a team. So if you want to compete and win and move on to better competitions, it just reminds me of like grassroots soccer. It's just pure capitalism. You find the players, you got to go buy the players. If you can buy the players that fit your team, you can go and you can win, right?
But the other thing is, can you make it like a money ball team where you look at the stats and you figure it out and you sign players that get the stats that you need? That's another thing that's curious. And we'll see how that plays out for us, because we do want to have some optimized players on our roster. Slowly but surely, I think it's going to take a while to get to that point, but we're hoping to set our team to be future, kind of a little bit future proof.
Yeah. Young players go too.
A bunch of stuff happening. These are just you got John Morosi all over the place, which is cool too, because he's a big time insider.
Yeah.
So he's breaking down the value of a stolen base on So Rare. So like they're giving you information, like maybe you want to look at the stolen base leaders, because number one in that category, that would be So Rare MLB point leader, Ronald Acuna Jr. So he's leading. Yeah.
He's always been great. He's been great with that. And he's a great player because he's so well-balanced. He gets all the other stats too. So you always want to pick players in fantasy that are well-rounded. Exactly. Acuna Jr., he's going to be on our radar for sure.
Exactly. So this guy here, Chris Dales, shout out to you. First ever podium. Came second place in the super rare division. He had first for a bit, but he couldn't hold on to it. But that's ridiculous.
Look at his team. This guy has either he's won it or he's spent some big money right now. Yeah. To get a team like that. Those are all the blue cards, red cards. You know he came to play for sure. Yeah. Wow.
It's fun to see the colorful. I mean, we're going to get there eventually. I mean,
we're going to build it. We're, like I said, it's capitalism. We're going to build our way up, and Teddy's deal is going to be a big step in that.
And as you can see, Joel Weisner actually won this Julio Rodriguez card for playing him this weekend. So that's like another utility. If you play these guys in your lineup, maybe you never know. You might end up with a limited card.
That's actually sick. I didn't even know that there was a giveaways like that. I didn't know they did that. And that's one that maybe he's flipping it already. We saw one on the open market.
It could be him. Exactly.
Check the min number on that.
And also, they've been inviting people to the 2023 MLB World Tour in Mexico. So obviously, when the teams go and play in Mexico, it looks like Solrare had a couple guests. So shout out to Cribs Cutler. He ended up getting invited. And he put a couple pitches out here. So they were playing in Mexico, and he's enjoying his time there. And right, Solrare is making it happen.
Yeah, it's cool. It's cool.
So let's look at our teams. This is this week. So
it's not as good.
80th finish. And don't look at our majors team, because obviously you can see a couple of our guys did not play.
Yeah.
We literally just dressed the second team to be able to get some extra XP for those players.
Yeah.
And even then, we still finished in the top two thirds.
It looks considering, like. Considering, not bad.
But our team that we were actually going for, we went to the Common All-Star, first time ever being in the Common All-Stars. And we finished 8,000 out of 22,000. So top third, not too bad.
Is it just me, or is this starting to get bigger? Like, I don't remember there being 22,000 people participating in the last few weeks.
I remember
it being 20,000. Then before that,
21,000 last week. Or no. Yeah.
21, was it 21? Okay. Maybe. So it's just only a little bit bigger than before. It's an interesting thing to track, because if we're tracking the growth of Solrare, then we're going to expect to see more and more people join these competitions as time goes on.
A great metric as well is the Twitter. And I think we're up a couple hundred followers from last week. I think we're around 9,300. So it's slowly getting there. They're slowly getting some traction. You hope over the MLB season, they start to accumulate some more users. But in the meantime, if you are finding it, you are early.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Our plan here, first of all, we have to set our team for the upcoming week. We haven't done that yet.
That's the best part.
So we should go back into the Common All-Star. I think we gotta improve on our finish here. So let's set a lineup.
We have lots of options
here. We have so many options.
But
remember, we can't set a second team now because we do have the one limited card. We're allowed to play in that other one. So we might have potential, because it looks like we have four starting pitchers.
We got a lot. Now, Zach Allen's playing really well, but I don't know. I like Gausman. I think he's on fire right now, but Alex Manoah is their ace. So I don't know, Joel, you pick this one. I think we go with one of the Jays players.
Yeah, I think we're gonna go with one Jay and one and Gallen in our starting roster.
Okay.
So
I mean, I'm good with that.
If you want to go with Gausman this time, we can do that.
He's just been on fire. He's just been playing really well.
Manoah had a decent game last time around. I ended up doing a swap, and we ended up getting a pretty decent relief pitcher in Bryce Wilson. But I do know that Presley has this plus 6.5. So I think we should still stick with him.
Okay, let's stick with him.
Here, I'll let you choose. I don't know. Corner, well, infielder,
all a couple Alec options. Baum. I think Alec Baum's our best player here.
He's got the 6.5.
Yeah.
Even here, I think we should stick with Luis Garcia.
Yeah, he has four games. He plays four games. Yeah, I got to go with him.
And then here, Bellinger.
He has the four games. Go with Bellinger. Yo, I'm tempted. What's that?
This guy has five games.
Maybe we should play him just because he has five games. Like, even though Adolis Garcia was a monster for us the other day,
he's only got two games.
He only has two games. So let's go with the five games and see. It's inevitable. He's going to get some points for us.
And then here, I think we go with the Allen again.
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah.
All right. So I think we've picked our team, which is cool. Let's see if we have enough to go for another team in the majors now.
Okay.
So we still have Manoah. So this team's looking better already.
Yeah.
Our relief pitcher, we can go this is our relief pitcher that we got. He's got plus 45%.
We're definitely using him.
Yeah.
We're definitely using him. Why is he plus 45%?
Because he's limited. So you get a 40 and then you get the 5% for
else. For this competition, it's plus 40. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
So let's go Brian Anders. Let's just go top, pick the top. Ryan McMahon.
Okay.
Adolis.
Let's play him. Throw him in.
And now we have an option for a flex.
Go Ward. Go Ward.
Ward, and we have a pitcher here, so we have to use him.
Just use the pitcher. I feel like with the point system, you want to play your pitchers with these point systems. They have a better opportunity than the hitters even.
I feel like we have a better chance on this majors than we did last week.
I think so as well. But you know what? We might want to revisit this because we're gonna buy another limited card. Should buy a card. Let's buy a limited card to beef up our ability to do well in the majors.
Okay,
yeah, let's do that. Let's do that.
I agree with you. So that'll give us a better percentage. Maybe we could double up on one of the players we actually have. But anyways, let's show you guys how you can buy.
Yeah,
you can click buy and sell. There's a couple options. There's starter packs, which they usually come out the day after a turn. So they're coming out tomorrow, and it'll be people who did well this week. And they give you a whole pack for like 70 bucks, but it's sometimes not the best players. It's kind of like the optimized lineup for that week. And who knows if they're going to ever repeat that. So I don't know how I feel about those yet.
If they're not giving us a judge, we should check tomorrow. But if we're not getting like a judge or like an Otani, it's not worth it.
Yeah. And new card auctions. So these are where the SoRare sends out players randomly and then people can bid and they close every so often. So every couple of minutes, it looks like 2.5 minutes intervals, a random player will close. And you can bid on them. So you can see the actual prices. You can see when they're closing and then you can try and buy them that way. But the other way is manager sales, which is other users selling it to you. So what I've done here already is I've brought up manager sales and we don't want to get too crazy yet. We're not going to go into rare, super rare or unique. Yeah. We're going to stick with a limited. So I just filed that off. And we also want it to be this season because there's a season bonus for that.
That's right, yeah.
So you can kind of get an idea of prices here, but Rob and I were talking. Rob, why don't you explain what we're thinking?
I don't know. I think that we should beef up our pitching. We want to get some more limited pitching that we can use. Mm-hmm. I mean, I like Kevin Gausman. I'm seeing some players that we already have here. He's a good price at 34, but maybe we should go for someone else because he's doing so well on the common side.
Yeah.
I don't know. Is there a Manoah maybe? We could pick up our other Jays ace. What's he at right now?
He's a little bit cheaper right now. So there's a couple of, if you click it, you'll see the two that are for sale.
Yeah.
One's $26.93 and one's $27.48. So
okay.
People might think pick the cheaper one, but what are we thinking here, Rob?
I don't know. I don't think I would because there's two reasons. The first reason is that that's a 5.5%. So this player has a little bit of experience to give us an extra edge. Very small price to pay for an extra like 50 cents. But probably more importantly is that if you look at the mint numbers here, that's a 19. And anyone who's not familiar with the crypto space, or should I say the NFT mint number space, lower mint numbers are typically better because the presumption is that it was minted first on the chain. Mm-hmm. And even in the physical world, if you're a collector of physical products, it's the same thing too. In the physical world, sometimes the ones that have the lower mint numbers, they should be the ones that were actually physically made first. So people think they're more desirable. Same goes for these cards. So we're going to definitely go with this one.
I think so. So this is our first ever limited purchase on the market. It's crazy to see. Like if you look at this, there are some going for bids. This one's closing in 32 minutes. This one's from it closing in a day. It's at 92 cents. So we'll have to see how that goes. But here's the ones that have closed before. So last limited sales, 22 hours ago, 15 bucks. 60 bucks, public offer 17, a couple days. So these prices are starting to increase based off of the way that they've been playing.
Yeah.
Being from Toronto, I think it only makes sense. So let us buy our Alek Manoah. We have our balance there.
Yeah. And don't forget, this is for our video. We like instant gratification on YouTube, right, guys? So we need, even though we're paying a little bit of a premium, we're going to do it.
I don't even know how to unlock my wallet. So hold on a second.
You gotta.
Oh, you just put your normal password in. Okay.
There you go.
It's not crazy. I just didn't want to show something that I didn't have to.
Yeah, we don't want you guys seeing our password. Not your keys, not your crypto, right?
So you can see he's gone there. Now let's check our cards. Let's go back to play and upcoming, and maybe he's already there. Hopefully. It's blockchain, so sometimes these things take a while.
Let's take a look. I mean, it is in their space.
He's there.
Yeah, it should be pretty quick.
So let's switch him out.
Let's switch him in. Let's use him.
There you go. So
actually, now that we're there, what's the other pitcher? If you go back, we were playing a second starting pitcher. I don't know if you could double up on the player?
I doubt it, but we can try. Let's check.
You know what I mean? Like you double up on the player, and if the player does well, you get like
edit team,
amazing points. I doubt it's going to let you.
No,
it doesn't let you. Okay. You can. That's fine. Okay. At least we have a pitcher who's playing.
I wonder if we have enough for a training team. Probably not.
I don't. You need, let's see. Yeah.
Oh, almost.
Okay. So we need a middle infielder.
And we need an outfielder. So we need a bunch of players.
Yeah, we don't have enough yet. Okay.
But that's cool. So now I'm excited. We have two limited players. We have Manoah coming in at plus 40%. We have a chance here now, Rob.
We do. I'm just curious. Are all the packs, if you hit choose pack, are they all sold out right now? All the packs?
Let's check. I think they probably are. Oh, no, they do have some packs. Okay, so here, you can see. $70. They're all the same price. There's five packs. And this says that this team would have come ninth out of 2,944.
But they're like the most random dudes.
It's random dudes. Like Hunter Renfro's on all the teams because he finished very high. I'm sure that some of these teams might have Adolis Garcia.
I bet you they will, yeah. But it's probably best, unless there's a player that you know you're going to actually just like you really want, I think it's better to hold off. Like you want to see some, I don't know. I feel like
Bambi Johnson.
That's not bad. I mean, at least you got one guy there, but you just want to see one player that you know is like worth his weight in value. And then that makes you feel better about dropping the 70. Like they're pretty expensive considering that you could spend the same amount of money and get three or four cards of players you actually really like and are really good.
And if you're patient on an auction, you might be able to really, really score. So that's, I think, what me and Rob might have to start looking at this week. We'll see if we can get some steals. We'll do it live.
Yeah, no, for sure. But this is our first purchase. We want to make sure we do it on video for everybody to see. Like I said, instant gratification is always a good thing, right? You come in here, you buy it right away, get it. Now we have it, we can use it. So, guys, let us know what you guys think. How'd you guys like today's video? What's over there? Are you involved? How are you setting your team? How did you finish this week? Did anyone best their 85th finish from last week? I don't know if we're going to ever be able to pull that off again, but we will try. As long as you play, you have a chance, right? They say you don't score 100% of the shots you don't take. So if you don't actually play, you never know if you're going to win. And you can get lucky like we did. We got really, really lucky with Adolis there, just knocking out three homers in one
game. That got us into the limited tournaments. We got in for free because of that. We won a limited card, right?
That's right. We hit exactly. So let us know your thoughts below. We read every comment, even if you don't respond. So make sure you comment below. And guys, if you have not already, do not forget, become a superstar, smash the subscribe button, join the superstar fam, hit the bell notification button to get every single video every single day. You know we're going to have every day covered for you guys. We got all your content, so make sure you join us. And also, Superstar VIPs, $2.99 a month. Get the star beside your name. Get access to our spreadsheets, our giveaways for a star in the universe from starnaming.com. And yeah, guys, thank you all so much for all of your support. Take care, and we'll see you next one. Bye-bye.
Love you. Bye.